27, you guys, most of you guys know the story behind this. Spafford, Horatio Spafford, a businessman in Chicago. Had a lot of businesses that are fired in Chicago. Burned his business now, lost his business. He sent his wife and two daughters across the seas, and they sailed off while he was trying to finish up on some of the business things that he had to do. And that ship collided with another one, and that ship went down. And he got a telegraph back from his daughter, I don't remember his daughter, but from his wife, said, "Saved alone." And so he knew that his two daughters had perished in that wreck. And so he got on the next ship heading across the seas, and the captain came and told him, "This is the place we think is about the place where your daughters had perished and that ship went down." He went down below, and this is what he penned: "It is well with my soul." So when you understand what Spafford went through, that he was trusting the Lord no matter what, I can't imagine what he was going through, but had enough to go back down to the bottom of the ship, and he penned these words that we're going to sing now: "It is well with my soul."
When peace I now
it is well.
that psalm and you think about what he went through and the trust that he had in his Savior and that he could depend on, knowing that, that someday he would see his daughters again. It is well with my soul. So, number 29, How Great Thou Art. Was put in there for Uncle Mickey. He's not here, but we'll sing it on his behalf. He loves this song, How Great Thou Art. When you think about what we're going to sing here, just picture the words as we're singing.
Oh, Lord, my God, when I hear awesome wonder, consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, I bow throughout the universe.
Psalm 51. It's 115 in the Psalm book. 115 in the Psalm books. We'll sing this and sing it through twice, and then from the samples we'll turn it over. Now listen, this is your last night. Last night to hear preaching. And I hope that God will speak to your hearts. Some decisions I made this week have been made this week, and which is exciting. Later on we're going to have some campfire time. And let me explain what we're going to do around the campfire. We'll have some s'mores and things like that. We'll have some, you can sign your books and stuff. You can start doing that then. But when we go into the testimony time, that's when we put the books away, and we'll just do some singing. All the fun side, all those, you know, I got preach like River. We're going to say those for later on when you guys are going home on the bus. But we'll sing some of the more serious songs, and then we'll open it up for testimony of what God has done in your heart this week. Give Him the praise, give Him the glory. And just sometimes when you just tell people about what God has done, hold you accountable. You know, some things that just hold you accountable. So that's me around the campfire here right after preaching tonight. And so just remember, it's a great time. It's probably one of the sweetest times of the camp that I like, just to hear what God has done in your heart throughout this week. We've had a lot of fun, but we've had a lot of good preaching as well. Here we go.
Create in me a clean heart.